All right. I'm here today with Will Miller from the Multihull Company. He was our broker when we purchased YOLO, our 42-foot Antares, and we're going to talk about what a broker does and how he fits into the boat buying process. So, Will, you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and your business in the Multihull Company?
Sure. I'm the owner of Charleston Sailing School and Yacht Charters, but I also have worked with the Multihull Company for the past decade, initially just assisting with training their new owners and relocating some of their boats as a delivery skipper, and that role eventually evolved into me as being a yacht broker. I had the opportunity to sail on a lot of different yachts and in a lot of different locations and really learn the ins and outs of the catamaran industry specifically. And I've worked the boat shows, both Miami and Annapolis, for the better part of 10 years now, and really enjoy the process of finding assisting my clients, from the very beginning of learning to sail and then progressing to the stage where they want to buy a boat.
Okay, and so for finding a boat for a prospective buyer, you help with that process as well. So do you just help them look on Yacht World, or where do you help them find
boats? Sure, it's similar to real estate where you can represent a buyer or a seller, and inherently having the sailing school, we attract a lot of clients that are thinking about buying a boat. So there's a dozen different websites out there that you can go to. A lot of it's word of mouth and knowing where these boats are and developing relationships. And our company's been around for the better part of 25 years now. So we have a lot of repeat customers that buy and sell boats through us. And it's, again, similar to real estate, sometimes those hot properties don't ever show up on the internet or on the MLS.
Okay. So you go through with a potential buyer on finding a boat, they select one, and then can you also help out with evaluation of the boat to try to give the possible purchaser an estimation of what would be a good value for that one?
Sure. The surveyor is going to put a fair market value on the boat when he performs the survey. But prior to that, it's our job to kind of go through comps and look at recent sold boat prices and equipment list and inventory and see how that's going to translate to that specific boat. And then, help the potential buyer put a valuation on that yacht.
Okay. How does someone become a yacht broker? For example, real estate agents, most of those guys need to go through some sort of schooling or certification for states usually. Is it the same for being a broker?
Not necessarily exactly the same. In Florida, they do have some licensing requirements. There's no classroom or training that yacht brokers have to go through. Okay. It's more of a establishing a reputation. Usually people who become yacht brokers are already involved in the industry and have networked through the industry and know different insurance agents and different banks and what have you. A lot of it is aligning yourself with the right brokerage. And having them promote you and putting their faith behind you as a broker.
So is that kind of what happened between yourself and the Multihull Company?
Correct. Yeah, I met Phil Berman about almost 15 years ago doing some yacht deliveries, and he's a very well respected name in the catamaran industry. And he took me under his wing and started feeding me some business, and I started feeding him some buyers, and the relationship evolved out of that.
When we start getting into the actual purchase of the vessel, do you hold escrow, or does your company, the Multihull Company, do any of that?
We do. Once an offer is made and accepted, 10% escrow is required in good faith, and that escrow is refundable at any time up until the acceptance date, which is after your due diligence period, after you've done your sea trial survey, personal inspection, lined up your financing and docking and what have you. So there are multiple outs. You can essentially reject the yacht at any point and get your escrow back.
You will help develop the contract between the purchaser and the seller, write that up, and then you were saying at any time you can pretty much back out if you find something you don't like with the boat?
Correct. Yeah. As the buyer, you do have several outs up until that acceptance date. Hopefully if you've gone through that process of making an offer, putting money in escrow, at a certain point you've invested some time and money because now you've paid for a survey, you've more than likely traveled to that survey. So it's, while there are several outs, usually people are only making offers and presenting written contracts if they're serious.
Okay. So, and as a broker, how are you paid? Is it similar to a real estate agent where they get a commission on the sale?
It is, exactly. It's a little bit higher with yachts because of the travel involved and the length of time that it takes to sell, you know, certain yachts. But it's conventionally worldwide 10%, and that's paid by the seller. So okay. The seller would pay, you know, if he only had a listing agent selling his boat, that selling agent would get the full 10%. If you come in with a buyer, it's usually split 50-50 between the listing agent and the buyer's agent.
Okay, so that just comes out of the seller's proceeds after the closing of the sale.
Right. Having a broker involved does not cost a buyer anything.
So it sounds like it'd always be a good time to have one.
It's a good thing to have. I mean, as much as a lot of buyers know about boats, really knowing the ins and outs of the purchase process and knowing where to get financing and where to get insurance is something that not everybody's an expert in.
And are there usually hurdles as far as regulations, maybe from state to state, or if you happen to try to purchase a boat outside of the United States?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it can be really difficult to buy boats internationally, particularly if you're trying to finance. A lot of U.S. banks don't want to finance a boat that's often, you know, some country halfway around the world where they can't necessarily go find it if you default. You know, and as far as domestic purchases, you know, state to state's not really much of an issue. But you do want to take the tax implications into account and know how much sales tax you're going to be paying, how much property tax you're going to be paying, and that sort of stuff that people don't think about. They don't incorporate that into their purchase price all the time.
Okay, and that's something that you as a broker would research and...
Sure, yeah, absolutely. I want people to know what they're signing up for, because it's not just sign the paper and walk away and you've got this you know, fancy new boat that's, you know, the bleeding starts right away. You've got dockage, you've got insurance, you've got maintenance the minute you buy a boat, whether it's new or used. And I try to prepare people for what that is. And, you know, there's some generalizations and, you know, whether it's a percentage of the value of the boat or, you know, just helping people assess what it's going to really cost to own the boat. But I do want people to be aware of what that is before they sign on the dotted line.
You're the buyer's broker, and we've just closed on a contract. Is there other support that you or any other broker would provide as far as maybe, I don't know, registration, documentation, any of that sort of thing?
Sure. We help outsource that stuff. We work with documentation agents around the world to, you know, it's a Canadian registry. It's got to be deleted and then imported into the United States. So we can set you up with customs brokers. We can set you up with documentation agents to properly document the boat. And prior to closing, of course, you want to do a proper lien and title search and make sure that the person who owns the boat really does own the boat, free and clear. And then we assist with refits, we assist with delivery, and really helping people get off the ground, finding dockage, you know, making recommendations as to, you know, where to keep the boat.
So what would you say is the best time for a potential buyer to come to a broker and say, hey, I'm looking at a boat, this is kind of what I'm thinking? Is that after they have already done their own research on Yacht World or Craigslist or wherever they're looking for a boat and say, hey, I want these five boats, come help me? Or would it behoove them to come to you before that?
It all is based on what their prior experience is, whether they've owned a boat before or, you know, whether this is their first time. There's a lot more handholding when it's their first time. It's an education process, you know, not only about what boats are available and what features they want, but, you know, how the purchase process works. If somebody's been through it before, it's more of facilitating the search process and helping them find the right boat and then getting them to, you know, the point where they're ready to make an offer and pursue a particular yacht.
Okay, so you said the boat purchase process. Can you do a quick synopsis of that from your view? So it's find a boat, buy a boat, register a boat? I'm sure it's more complicated than that.
Well, a lot of it is the search process. A lot of it is looking and trying to find the right boat initially and helping people decide what type of sailors they're really going to be. Mm-hmm. A lot of people search on a dollars per foot basis and they want to buy the biggest boat they can afford. And that's not necessarily the right criteria. You need to determine whether you're going to be a day sailor or hang out on the boat on weekends or whether you're going to spend a season on it. You know, maybe you're a teacher or something like that, and you've got seasonal work and you can spend 2 or 3 months living aboard, or whether you're going to commit, sell everything and consolidate your life onto a small boat. So finding the right criteria and finding the type of boat you want first is the majority of the process. Okay. And then beginning the search, you know, facilitating showings, whether we're handling the showings. Usually a listing agent will offer a courtesy showing to one of our buyers. If they travel, you know, say the boat's listed down in Florida and I'm up here in South Carolina, they will facilitate and help, you know, show a boat down there. And then once they've decided on a particular yacht, you know, helping them make an offer, deciding, you know, putting an evaluation on the boat, researching some of the sold boat prices on comparable yachts, you know, coming together with dates for the acceptance and the closing, the location of the closing, where you're going to take possession of the yacht, any other stipulations that you want in there, and specifically going through the inventory really well and seeing what's going to convey with the yacht. Okay. That's, you know, there can be really big ticket items on there that are, you know, $10,000 to $15,000 items that may or may not be omitted, may show up in a picture, but may not be in the inventory, which means they don't necessarily have to be working or be present at the time of closing. So you really want to iron out that that inventory prior to making an offer or having that offer accepted.
And do you normally travel then for that as the broker?
Not necessarily for the showings, but once we have the boat under contract and we start the due diligence phase, which would be performing the sea trial and survey, I'm generally always there for the sea trial and survey. Okay. I want to see the yacht in person. I want to go through it with the surveyor, be there to ask any questions that the buyer may not be picking up on. You know, a lot of the selling agents or listing agents can kind of sweep stuff under the rug and highlight the really nice features and, right, you know, some of the other defects, you know, they may try to brush over or play off. So you really need to be there to dig a little bit deeper when you have the surveyor standing right there to help you understand what really does need to be done to fix a certain issue on the boat or what inventory is missing. And then after the due diligence period of the sea trial and survey and assisting with lining up financing and lining up the insurance, then usually the buyer is ready to accept the yacht. And you don't want to sign that acceptance unless you are 100% ready. If you sign that acceptance and for whatever reason decide you're not going to close, at that point you do lose your escrow. Okay. So that's the day that is make it or break it, essentially. You don't take possession that day, but at that point you're signing on the dotted line that you're buying that yacht. And then once you have that acceptance, usually there's a 7 to 10 day period where the paperwork is put together, the closing documents, the abstract of title is done, the bill of sale and all the closing papers are prepared, and then everybody signs and you take possession of the yacht.
So is there anything else that I might have missed about the boat purchase process in particular, or what a broker does?
No, I would say that financing is becoming more and more difficult. You know, people think that because they can go out and buy a $500,000 or $600,000 home, that they can go out and buy a yacht that's $200,000 or $300,000, and that's not necessarily the case. The laws are very stringent with financing this day and age, and it's not always easy. And the age of the yacht can preclude financing. Most banks won't finance boats that are over 15 or certainly 20 years old. And the location of the yacht, you know, if it's outside of the U.S. or if it's not registered in the U.S., you know, people look at boats in the Med or the Caribbean and they go, oh, well, that boat's $100,000 less than the boat in Florida. Yeah, but if you can't get the financing, you can't buy the boat, you know. So a lot of buyers do bring their boats from all over the world to the U.S., and you will see boats that are listed not for sale to U.S. residents while in U.S. waters, which essentially means that they haven't been imported. And you'll see that fairly regularly, where a foreign owner will bring the boat into U.S. waters and not import it until they know they have a U.S. buyer. And then they'll start the import process, because the boat cannot be sold in the U.S. until the boat has been imported. It technically can't be shown in the U.S. to a U.S. buyer until it's been imported.
Okay, and the import process, that's basically you're just paying taxes on bringing it to the United States.
Yeah, it's 1.5%, and that's paid by the seller typically prior to closing. And that's on an assessed value that the customs broker determines.
All right. Does that normally extend the purchase process by a week, a month?
It depends. It depends where the boat is and how quickly they can get a customs agent there to do the assessment and process the paperwork. But it can take 2 to 3 weeks at least just to get through that process.
Yeah, I had a friend of mine, he purchased his boat and it was in BVI. And that was one of the stipulations, that they had to bring it over to the USVI when he actually took possession of it.
And one other thing to be aware of is that you can have a US flagged vessel that has not been imported into the US. So if a boat went straight into charter in Tortola and never came into the United States, and the US Virgin Islands are tax-free, so they can cross back and forth between the US and British Virgin Islands, but the minute that the boat were to touch the U.S. mainland or even Puerto Rico, then that import tax is going to be assessed and people will go and buy a U.S. flagged yacht, assuming that it's already had its duty paid, and they get the boat home and all of a sudden the tax man comes to them with their handout.
And is that part of the due diligence you were saying that the broker would uncover?
It's something that would be uncovered during the documentation phase, and usually boats are marketed with tax paid or tax not paid. But it's certainly a question to have answered prior to placing a boat under contract.
Is that like title insurance that you're getting against a boat?
The documentation agent is going to try their best to make sure that you have free and clear title and know where duties have been paid and where the boat's documented and where it needs to be registered, you know, yep. Helping you understand the tax implications of where you're going to register the boat also.
So if somebody wants to get a hold of you to purchase a boat through the Multihull Company, how would they go about doing that?
They can reach out to me directly. My cell phone number is 843-364-4123, or my email is will@multihullcompany.com.
Thanks for the interview, and I appreciate it.
And thank you.
Yeah, we'll be back down here soon, I'm sure.
I hope to see you sailing.